This video covers three simple data structures, stacks, queues, and double-ended queues. To understand the implementations here, you should first understand the linked list and dynamic array videos found in this playlist. After seeing the basic operations for each data structure, we'll cover two main implementation strategies. Stacks hold items in a last-in, first-out order. Whenever you take something from the stack, you get the thing that was put into the stack most recently. We talk about the top and the bottom of the stack. The idea is that if you have a stack of things and you want one, you take one from the top, and when you add to the stack, you add to the top. For a non-empty stack, the bottom doesn't change, though sometimes it might look like it's moving if it's like a stack of cafeteria trays and one of those spring-loaded thingies. Anyway, for a stack, inserting and deleting are traditionally known as pushing and popping. Not that kind of popping. You might also have some other operations, though of these, only size gives you something that you don't get easily from push and pop. You can simulate peaking by popping and then repushing an element. And when you do that, if there isn't anything to pop, you know the stack was empty. Queues, on the other hand, hold items in a first-in, first-out order. When you remove something from a queue, you get the thing that's been there the longest. In the States, we say this is like getting in line or lining up, but elsewhere they call that line a queue, and they might say you're queuing up. You move towards the front of the queue from the back or rear, and traditionally, insert and delete are known as NQ and DQ. Notice that for a queue, peak does give you a new ability, which can't be easily replaced by DQ and NQ, because once you're out of line, you have to go to the back to get back in. Finally, we have a double-ended queue, or deque. Some have also used a longer abbreviation, but because that's spelled like the operation for deleting from a queue, let's go with the shorter name. For deques, operation names aren't standardized. Knuth calls the two ends left and right, and I'll call the operations insert and delete, but all kinds of different names are used. Notice, different sources might use push for different inserts and pop for different deletes. Now, it's pretty clear that if you have a deque implementation, that can give you a queue or stack implementation easily. But in some cases, stacks or even queues can have somewhat simpler underlying structures. Starting with a linked list implementation, doubly linked lists give a really easy way to implement deques. We can insert or delete from the head position, call that the left, and insert or delete from the tail position, call that the right, done. Even with the optional size and peak operations, all operations take constant time. The animation here showed insert left and delete right. The other two operations are similar. For a regular queue, I'll show insertion at the tail and deletions from the head, and it turns out that for those, we can actually use a singly linked list with a tail reference. For regular queues, we don't need the doubly linked list structure underneath. A singly linked list will do. Stacks are even simpler. You can use that singly linked list without even keeping a tail reference. Just push to and pop from the head location. For an array-based implementation, let's start with the simplest one, stacks. We can directly use our dynamic array to implement the stack. We know it can insert or delete from the array's last position in average constant time. If we just call that last position the top of the stack, we're done. For queues, things get a bit more complex. There might be a few different array-based approaches, but I'm going to use circular arrays. They're simple and elegant, but still efficient. Instead of using a prepackaged dynamic array like ArrayList, we instead build a new data structure from arrays, but we use the same ideas and analysis that were used to build dynamic arrays. So like dynamic arrays, we allocate an array with fixed capacity, keep separate track of the size of our structure within that array, and reallocate when our size grows beyond the capacity. Really, the only changes are that we won't force the first element of the array to be the first location within the array, and we will allow ourselves to wrap around when we get to the end of the array if the first position isn't being used. So for queues, when we enqueue, we start by adding to the end of the array, just like normal, and if we queued right past the capacity of the array, it would look just like our growing dynamic array. But at some point, we dequeue. We return and remove the first element, but instead of trying to shift everything towards the front of the array, instead, shift the logical start of the queue over by one. After doing that a few times, the front of the queue moves further back within the array. Next, if you enqueue up to and then past the end of the array, just wrap to the front of the array and add the element there. If we do our increments and indices modulus the capacity of the array, the calculations are really simple. Resizing is like in dynamic arrays, except we always copy the logical starting index to the new array location 0 and wrap around in the old array when copying from it as needed. The new array will have everything indexed nicely from 0 when it's first created. For Deques, the same logic works. You just need to rename enqueue to insert right, dequeue to delete left, and then write symmetric insert left and delete right methods that will sometimes wrap the index from the first position of the array back up to the last one. Check out the rest of the playlist or the other playlists on my channel, but it's time for my popping lesson.